Hey guys, I'm Cicely Junior here, aka Mustached, and welcome back to some more Death Stranding. Alright, let's start off with some mail time. Mountain Knot City is now part of the UCA. Lockney explained how it all was all a big misunderstanding. What a relief. The Tar's all gone thanks to that bomb. This is gonna sound weird, but you know, the Ordric on Mama's left shoulder didn't used to think much of it, but someone told me it was a symbol of Mama's atonement. Even though her child was taken from her, Mama couldn't let it go, and so she instead broke her bond with Lockney. Couldn't help but think of herself beyond redemption after that, like a fallen angel forever barred from heaven. An Abzifabio, that one winged fellow who followed Beelzebub down to Egypt once upon a time. Guess Mama was feeling poetic when she redesigned the Ordric and used to comfort her dead child. Strange, maybe, though. I suppose she was already dead herself. Looks like all that's in the past now, though the misunderstanding has been resolved. And the sisters are whole again, thanks to you, Sam. My mom can finally work up the courage to cut the cord and send her baby off to the other side, where it belongs. So the two are one, and the fallen angel got a second chance. Just as well, cause no one's ever really beyond redemption, I'd like to think. Well, I don't know about that. Anyway, so to the super honorable Mr. Sam Bridges, it gives me the great pleasure to report that the way station patch-up job went off without a hitch. That stuff you brought us was just what we needed, man, and now we're part of the network, too. No way station is an island, not anymore. We could talk to HQ over the East Coast just like if they were in here in the room, which is, that's how we heard those rumors about Central were true. Totally wiped out, huh? Damn. And if it hadn't been there, the UCA's plans would have gone up in the tubes, down the tubes. Glad that didn't happen. Keep on keeping on. Don't stop till you hit the ocean. Alrighty then. Let's get he's telling me no. Like, can I leave? Am I missing something here? Oh. Well, that's not good.
Man.
Okay.
You may recall me explaining that these incubators connect BBs via the chiral network to their still mothers back at HQ. Bridge babies are quite literally bridges between this world and the other side. Their place is not here with us, nor with the BTs over there. They belong precisely in between. With no greater affinity.
I don't remember him having scars on his head.
The BB-28 here has been leaning further and further towards the world of the living. Towards you, Sam. It's because we're partners. Partners? Sam, a baby's a tool, not a human being.
Ah, jeez.
Bridge, yes. Baby, no. So tell me what the problem is. This tool, this weapon, is transforming into a living being. It's gaining weight. Its brain activity is increasing. It's accumulating memories. BB-28 is becoming self-aware, becoming an actual child.
Doesn't sound like a problem to me.
It's hardware, Sam. Manufactured for a purpose. A purpose that cannot fulfill outside the pod. There is a 70% risk of catastrophic failure simply in removing it. Which hardly matters because at this point, it'll cease functioning within a couple of days.
Cease functioning?
That's right. Not even the pod will be enough. It'll be bricked.
What do we do?
We reset it. You'll have to leave it with me, of course. I'll cut the cord that links the two of you and then perform an operation that reconnects it to the other side. Think of it as a little tug to correct its alignment. To put it back where it belongs, right between the world of the living and the dead. But like I said, you'll have to be without it for a while.
Ah, jeez.
You're sure this will work?
Of course. One catch, though. The surgery may erase its memories.
Erase? Oh, forget me?
Relax. The BB will still function as intended. You just have to trust me. Come on. I'm telling you, it's like a game. Just let me try and start again. And this is why I hate these things. Sam. I was already filthy. Now your BB has added insult to injury.
BB doing actions.
Some digging into the first BB experiments. Officially, they were suspended by the government following a FOIA which claimed the life of the then acting president. Documents were shredded. BB technology banned, yes? But obviously, the experiments continued in secret on the direct orders of President Strand.
President?
Central to solving the mystery of the Death Stranding. They weren't designed just to be BT detectors. She wanted to incorporate them into the Chiral network to facilitate travel to the beach. But none of her plans ever came to fruition. And now BB Tech has fallen into terrorist hands.
What's Diarmid's part in this?
I'm afraid to find out. I don't know how long he was working for Strand. I don't even know his real name or his face. I thought you might, since you two go further back.
He was already wearing a mask when I met him. Something about burning his face.
Right. Sorry. Anything that we have from back then is classified at the highest level. As far as I know, the director is the only one with clearance. But the Chiral Network presents a new opportunity. By compiling fragmented data in the public domain from all across the country, I might be able to piece together a little more of the puzzle. Be careful, Stan. They're watching. Well, Sam, you're a good sport. I'll give you that. Still, it's a fine way to get out of doing the laundry.
Just fix BB, all right?
Oh, no. You'll be doing the fixing. I'd never manage without your help. Check the delivery terminal upstairs for the details. When you're ready, of course.
Huh. Okay, let's get the ficky out of here. Well then. Something tells me now that I don't have it, something terrible is going to happen to me.
Second, it'll be easy to win them over. We'll have trust, bit by bit, job by job. Another thing, Sam, you'll be making runs without a BB for a spell. That will vastly diminish your ability to detect BTs. So keep your eyes and ears open for anything out of the ordinary, and stay the hell out of the rain if you can help it.
Well,
sister's place and provide you with support. We're all again. One. Forever and always. We still speak, so I shouldn't have any trouble getting up to speed.
You back with Bridges then?
It's not about that. Never was. It's about what she wants. What we want. And why shouldn't we help you? You helped us. We're all connected now.
About going the way.
Thank you.
God damn it. Oh, so they do come out in the snow. I even saw that one, and I was bumping and flumping, and I jumped right into it. Oh, jeez. Oh, for fuck's sake. There's two of them. Nothing I can really do about that. Thank you. DB has been named at some point, Lou. I don't know when that happened. I guess he just decided that that's his name. Or her name. Not really sure. Great.
I hear you're the one to talk to about the Chiral Network. Is it true that a contractor let me access your schematics and so forth? I want to share my research with everyone. Let them read it. Let them learn from it, like I learned from their work. Make me a part of the UCA.
No problem. Bop, beep, beep, bop. Terrain skeleton.
Very good, very good. Guess we're in this together now, Sam. I'd love to show you around the place, but it's a terrible mess.
I see you've put another shelter on the network. Nice job. Chiral levels are increasing as predicted, which is good. As for BB-28, you'll be pleased to hear the operation went well. There should be no need for additional major procedures. We're not out of the woods yet, but I think it's safe to say that the worst is behind us. All that remains is to continue expanding the network, monitor changes as chiral levels increase, and make adjustments as necessary. Drug therapy should suffice. Keep it up, Sam.
Yay.
Good morning. New order available. Please access delivery terminal for further information.
Oh, that's the roboticist's custom-made active skeleton, isn't it? Should be a big help on mountain trails or any lousy road, come to think of it.
Let's do it. fact, I guess. And then I'll save it when I get there, and that'll be that. Hopefully I won't get pulverized again. Yeah, now I'm trucking through the snow. Trucking along at the speed of snow. Got a truck out here. Damn it! Why the yellow? What the hell? What's all that about? That one isn't as bad. Alrighty, time to get out of here. Yeah, might as well. That looks really close. Longer on the grid.
As young as I once was, but I've still got plenty to offer. Oh, by the way, I came across something I thought you might find useful.
Uh-huh.
You're more than welcome to it.
Big jug.
Saved is one fewer BT to deal with. which in the long run means even more lives are saved. Please, don't give up. No matter how difficult it may become, I implore you.
Thanks, Sam. BB-28 appears to be on the road to recovery. Its affinity with the other side is growing stronger, as we hope. The convulsions and spasms have ceased as well. I know it's tough out there without a BB, but you've got to keep on fighting the good fight. Just like the kid is. Just like BB-28 is.
Sam, we've received an order from a new client. Check the terminal in Mountain Knot City for the details, and do it soon. Sounds like someone is in need of medicine.
Good work. New order available. Please access delivery terminal for...
Alrighty. I finally got the lockdown on why Lockney didn't want us to be part of the UCA. Can't say I understand at all, truth be told, but her concern that bringing everything and everyone into the fold might mean including some elements better left out, I get. If you take a step back, you can see how terrorism and war might not only get worse once we're whole. Forging bonds between people means bringing them closer together, and to do that means putting all our cards on the table, including the ones that aren't so pretty. It's naive to expect things to be all smiles and sing-alongs just because we understand each other a little bit better, you know? Seems to me she was right to call bullshit on that. Lockney and Mama were joined by the special bond that twins have. That's how come Mama wanted to carry Lockney's child, a child that should have been brought them closer together, but didn't. Instead, it served to sever the ties between them for good, and bound Mama to something else entirely. At least, that's what Lockney probably thought. Maybe even that her sister wanted the kid all to herself. She never knew about the accident, the real reason. Can't imagine how she must have felt, thinking she'd been betrayed by the one person she trusted more than anyone. Not so hard to see how they color her opinions on the Kyle Network. It's all behind her now, though. She and Mama have reconciled their differences, and maybe her faith in the ties that bind can be restored. Alrighty. I cannot save here.
Thank you, my friend.
Alright, now that we're already here, now let's save it. Alrighty, if you ended up enjoying this part, then please feel free to like, comment, and subscribe. Also, make sure to check out those links in the description. One will head over to my Discord server, the other to my Patreon page. Any donations are greatly appreciated. And until next time, everyone, bye-bye.